Well, thank you for the opportunity tonight to come and speak. I shared my story here a few years ago, but I'm going to go ahead and rehash just a little bit to inform you guys of where I was. What I want to convey to you tonight is what Crossroads did to help me. Hopefully we can land there and I don't jabber on and go off on a tangent, because that's the important thing. That's why you're here. And let me say thank you to everybody that is here, because it's people who help and people who support and volunteer and all those things that make it possible to help people like me, like Royce and Jody. You know, as I watched that video, I worked with Royce. When I seen his face, I knew who he was. It was a long time ago. He was a drinker, I was a drugger. Neither one of us were healthy. So it just kind of touches my heart to see him and to know what God did in his life. I had no clue. It's amazing. Crossroads was a part of that. So I ended up in Crossroads after spending 2.5 years in prison. Several years of methamphetamine abuse, a variety of other drugs, and a life of stealing to provide for my habit. You know, you can only steal stuff so long before you start getting caught, even if you think you're slick. I thought I was slick. But the cops had my number and I kept getting arrested, and I couldn't quite catch on why. Certainly it wasn't drugs, right? But it was there in the county jail, in Merritt County Jail in Central City, Nebraska, that a lady named Eileen came to me and talked to me about the Lord. And she used little kid stories that I'd probably tell my son today, but it worked for me. And one day she said, "You know, son, you just need to confess." She wasn't saying that I needed to confess to the 20-some charges that I had racked up and looking at. And I knew that. She was talking about confessing to God. Like my grandpa would say, you need to get right with God, son. And that's true. And in my jail cell that night, I broke down and I gave my life to Jesus Christ and asked him to save me and help me. And he did, because he can do that. I encourage the youth group that I work with a lot of times that God is big enough. Do you think he's not big enough to handle this or to handle that? He is big enough. God is big enough to handle anything and everything. And he was big enough to take me, a drug addict, a washed up loser, sleeping wherever I could, and give me a new life. So at 2.5 years, when they were about ready to kick me out of the door, I had to have a place to go. And so I looked at all the normal options, halfway houses and going back to my parents' house and doing all those things, and it just never really sat with me. And that same lady, we've been writing letters back and forth for 2.5 years, still communicating. She'd send me, you know, stuff to encourage me and help me walk. She said, "You know, I heard something on the radio about a place called Crossroads. You ever think about maybe going there and giving it a shot? It's faith-based. It might be really, really what you're looking for and what you need." So I said, this is how I do it with God sometimes. I pray, "Lord, if this is what you want, I don't have too much time to think about it. If it's open, I'm going," you know? It's like the shotgun prayer, where I just throw it out there. I don't know if that's what you're supposed to do all the time, but. And I called there, and within 3 minutes, I was off the phone and told my counselor that was in the prison there, kind of setting up my case to get out, that I had a place to go. And the door to Crossroads is open for me. And here's the thing that I love about Crossroads that Royce already hinted at. He said this. He said, they didn't rush you through. It wasn't here, come here for 30 days, fly through the program, get out, because we got another person coming. No, you can come here and stay for free. Eat our food, do all those things, and get your life back on track. No cost to you. That's a huge thing for somebody coming out of prison. You don't know how many friends that I know that got out, didn't have nowhere to go, or chose not to go to the wrong places, but ended right back up because of the pressures of life. But Crossroads offered me an oasis, a place to get my feet back on the ground and in slow steps through the programs. And one of my favorite things is watching Jerry play the guitar and sing. I got to say that again, because this is great, Jerry. But we would worship every morning. And we would come and we'd sing praise to God and get into His Word a little bit in the morning as a group. And man, how encouraging is that if you could do that every day, every morning with a group of guys and people who are like, man, we need the Lord. We need the Lord. Our life's a mess. We need Him. And because of Crossroads, I was able to buy a car. I went to college. I never thought I was going to go to college, man. I just like got through school barely. I graduated as the honor student of the automotive program. That's like home ec, if you guys don't know. That's really easy to get through. But God has blessed me richly with the job. And I'd say one of the most monumental things that happened at Crossroads was I met a guy named Truck Screen. And he introduced me to ministry. I started working with young boys that are locked up in drug treatment only just a few months after getting out of prison. I've been doing that for 7 years. I've actually just stepped out of that. I did it. And now I'm the youth pastor at the Hastings Berean Church. I'm not throwing a plot out for the Bereans or anything like that. This is where I'm at. But God has given me a new life, and He used Crossroads. If I'm not making it clear enough, He used the Crossroads for me to land, to get my feet on the ground. And the people that I met at Crossroads, I'm still with today. It's the people I met at Crossroads who got me involved in ministry, who gave me a chance to walk instead of taking off, hit the door running outside of prison, and just make this thing work. And I thank the Lord for the Crossroads. I thank the Lord that He led me there. It was like, boom, boom, Lord, here I go. And I haven't regretted it a day since. I met my lovely wife. We've been married 5 years this month. A lot of exciting things going on this month, I guess. And our son is two. Thank you for that, by the way. That was really cool. So we appreciate that. And I could ramble because I'm just kind of a talker sometimes in certain situations, but know that what you do, guys, and what you're helping with helped change my life. It gave me a firm footing. Thank you. Thank you.